Hey guys, welcome to Lingua Marina. In this video, I would love to go through a step-by-step plan on how you can go from A2 level of English to B2 level of English. And there is actually a huge gap between these two levels. And in this video, we're gonna try to assess your current level of English. Of course, in order to make a formal assessment, you should take a language test, but for the purpose of this video, I want you to be able to see where you are right now, and I will give you a step-by-step plan on how to improve and become B2. Quick background on me, I was born and raised in Russia, spent 25 years in Russia, then moved to the US. English is my second language, German is my third language, Italian is my fourth language. I speak German, I think right now it's a B1, B2 level. It used to be C1 because I used to study in Dresden. I was there for a semester studying mathematics, and I also learned Italian for 2 years. I think I stopped at A2 level. It was something like a hobby, but the thing is, I've gone through the process of learning a language 3 times in my life when it comes to a foreign language, and 4 times in my life when it comes to learning a language in general. So let's start. Watch this video up to the very end because I will give you the whole schedule that you can implement starting today. So first of all, let's look at the 6 levels of English language proficiency. They are called A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. A1 meaning starter, beginner, C2 meaning proficient, master. And basically A1 and A2 are your basic levels, C1, C2 are your proficient levels. This is according to CEFR, Common European Framework of Reference. So in the US system, we're actually talking about going from level 2 to level 4, and they have names here. So level 2 is a high beginner, and level 4 is high intermediate. And of course, when we're talking about your level of English, we're talking about 4 aspects of the language. We're talking about reading, writing, listening, and speaking. Now let's dive deeper into these 2 levels. I'm gonna divide my screen here. So here you're A2. Here, B2. So at this level, you know from 1,500 words to 2,000 words. If you want to go to B2, you need to know 3,000 to 4,000 words. Now, when it comes to listening, at A2 level, you're able to understand people talking about family, work. I have a family of 4, I have 2 kids, Emily is 4, Lily is 2. My main job is a YouTube influencer. I also run a company that helps people learn languages. It's called LinguaTrip. We have amazing teachers there. B2, personal and professional conversations. I've recently attended an AI conference where I met a prominent investor. His name is Vinod Khosla. He is a co-founder of Sign Microsystems. And his prediction is that AI is going to replace most teachers and doctors by 2028. And when he said that, I was kind of freaking out. So this is your example of a personal slash professional conversation. And you're also able to understand movies here. How are you doing with movies, guys? Let me know down in the comments below. By the way, movies, no subs, no subtitles. If they are about everyday things, right? I'm not talking about a documentary about nuclear weapons. I'm talking about a day-to-day movie. So you should be good here. But nuclear weapons, if it's on Netflix, maybe you're able to understand that as well, depending on how hard it is. How are we doing? Comment down below where you feel you are right now. And we're gonna continue. This is not it. So we talked about vocabulary. We talked about your listening skills. If you're A2, you're able to understand texts and simple letters. And a great example would be a bus schedule or a train schedule. Here at B2, you're able to read newspapers and you're able to understand and read technical words. Now here, when it comes to writing, you can write quick messages, postcards, happy birthday. And you're also able to take notes in English. Here, you're able to handle all kinds of writing, even business messages. Hello, dear investor. Here's an update on how our startup is doing. We've been growing 20% month over month and looking at an annual revenue of $10 million. We are about to raise our Series B and we have some prominent VC firms interested in the round, but we decided that we will let you know that we have some availability before we close the round. This is something I would say B2, C1 type of a business email if you are interested in Silicon Valley type of business, VCs, etc. Now, when it comes to speaking, here we have simple conversations, talk about friends, and most importantly, give compliments. It's my favorite way to practice English. You just walk in the street in an English-speaking country, you say, "Nice jacket. Oh my God, where'd you get your shoes? Oh, I love your sweater. Where'd you get it?" Very American. Now, B2, conversations with native speakers, and very important, debates. You can argue in English. You can negotiate in English. You can support your point of view in English. When I was back in Russia and I took part in it was called Olympiads back then, but basically competing with others in how good our English was, they would always ask us to participate in debates. Now, when it comes to grammar, here, you know, adjectives and their comparative degrees, good, better, the best, bad, worse, the worst. You know, tenses like past continuous or past progressive, you know, phrasal verbs. You know how to use modal verbs like must, can, could, should, have to. When I mention this, doesn't mean that if you take a test, you make no mistakes. The thing is, at A2 level, you don't have to know all the phrasal verbs, but you have to have some foundation because you definitely start learning them when you're at this level. Present perfect, adverbs of frequency, frequently, rarely, etc. And some other things. And even zero and first conditional are parts of A2 level. Zero and first conditional. Now, of course, at B2, you know lots of grammar. Future perfect continuous, piece of cake. Future perfect, you got it. Mixed conditionals, you know them. Mixed conditionals, all tenses. You're using phrases like, if only I knew this. Wish you were here. Like, all of these grammatical structures are part of this level, B2. Now, you're probably asking, Marina, so where is my study plan? How do I get from A1 to B2? While watching this video, you probably noticed that some areas of language seem harder for you. For example, when I was mentioning all of those mixed conditionals, you're like, yeah. Maybe you had a feeling that you don't even know everything that you're supposed to know when you're A2. And this is where you should pay some extra attention. And this is where, if I were you, I would start the learning journey, because when you're just starting out, you have a lot of motivation and you have all the energy to tackle the hardest things. I'll tell you a story. When I was learning German, my level was A2. I went to Germany, stayed with a local family, spoke German every single day, and of course my speaking skills became much better. But that also meant that I had to pay special attention to my grammar, because yes, I was speaking German, but my grammar just wasn't there. So when you start your learning journey, start with the hardest thing. And don't let your ego pull you away from that trajectory, because sometimes your ego tells you, oh, but my language sounds so good. Let me just forget about grammar. Like, who needs grammar if I can speak the language? Because I made the same mistake and then it was really hard for me to catch up. So learn from my mistakes. Step number two, find the time when you're the most productive. Like for me, that would be morning time. When I wake up, if I had a good night's sleep. That is not always the case, because my daughter Lily is 2 years old and sometimes she wakes up at night. So for example, last night I didn't have enough sleep, but that's fine. But I know that morning is the best time for me, because then I have lunch and then my energy goes down. And if I need to accomplish a more complicated task, the ideal time for me is in the morning. What really works for me is blocking off a slot in my calendar. Like 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Marina is, you know, learning German, learning Italian, whatever. Then after you're blocked the slot in your calendar, you know that every day you have like 20 minutes to learn English, maybe an hour, you pick your English learning style. Of course, I feel like the most convenient thing to do is to find a tutor who you like and learn with them. Two problems here are sometimes they're expensive, and number two, that doesn't allow you to be flexible. And if you have a baby, like, you just can't plan anything. Things happen all the time. So the second option is to take an English language course. For example, my company specializes in creating courses for English language learners. We have amazing teachers who are native speakers working for our company, and we create these courses all together. And we have a course called From Elementary to Intermediate, where every lesson is not a 60-minute class. It's a pre-recorded video, and it lasts from 10 to maybe 20 to 25 minutes, which means that, for example, if on Tuesdays you only have 20 minutes to learn English, you can find a suitable lesson for that day. If there are some days when you have more time, we have additional tests that you can take to practice what you've just learned. We have some tips on how you can work on your accent. We have some practice tasks. And of course, we cover all aspects of the language that you need to improve in order to become B2. And I have recorded several motivational classes for that course that will help you boost your energy and motivation to learn English. So if that's your case, if you want to take an online course to help you become intermediate in English, please feel free to click the link down below and join our course. I would love to see you there. Now, the next way to learn English is to go to a language school, either in a country where the language is spoken or in your own country. And the fourth method is solo learning, when you have your textbooks, when you have your apps, etc. So it really depends on what makes you the most productive and what helps you the most. Now, the final step here is your study plan. And this is what we're going to work on right now. So what needs to be included in your study plan? Vocabulary. Aim for 5 to 7 new words a day, not more, because otherwise it wouldn't work. Study topics like family and relationships, appearance, work, music, education, transport, houses, environment, travel, sport, holidays. And with every extra step that you take in your language, try to pay this extra attention to how native speakers pronounce certain words. And of course, construct sentences with the new vocabulary, try to learn idioms, try to watch more movies and read more books. Now, number 2, your listening skills. Listen to English every day. It could be a podcast, it could be an audiobook. Then summarize what you've just heard. Try to tell a story to your imaginary friend about what you just heard. Try to take notes. Practice your note-taking skills. You will need them in case you decide to take a test or study at an American or a British university. Break down song lyrics from your favorite music artists. And of course, watch English videos, YouTube, Netflix. Start with subtitles and then try without them and see what happens. Here are some ideas on what to watch for intermediate level. Dead to Me, Emily in Paris, Stranger Things, The Hunger Games, The Little Things, This Is Us, Soul. Now 3, reading. Read regularly. I'm going to recommend some books in a moment. Focus on comprehension. Try to understand the main idea and gradually increase difficulty of what you're reading. And also, friendly advice, just don't push yourself. If a book that you've selected is complicated and you're not enjoying it, you need to look up every single word, like every third word. Stop right there. Try something else. Try another book that is easier. Everything has to be enjoyable. You can't learn just by constantly pushing yourself. Yes, that works from time to time, but not all the time. So I'd say 10 to 20% in general in our life, 10 to 20% of the time we're pushing ourselves, 80% we should enjoy ourselves. So if that is not the formula for your life, maybe ask yourself some questions. Am I doing the right thing? Why am I not enjoying my day to day? Okay, sometimes you are at this stage of your life where you kind of have to push through, like your university or school, and then you push through and then you decide whatever you want to do. But yeah, you have to be enjoying whatever you're doing. Books for the intermediate level. The Perks of Being a Wallflower, The Book Thief, The Girl with All the Gifts, About a Boy, and there are a lot more. Just go to a bookstore and see whatever catches your attention. Try The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F-U Word by Mark Manson, one of my favorite books in the world. Tim Ferriss, The 4-Hour Work Week. I love that one. They are kind of basic, so try. I feel like you're gonna understand them. Now, of course, work on your writing. I know ChatGPT can write anything for you these days, but still work on your writing because you have to write your prompts for ChatGPT, right? Ideally, get feedback. So if you're writing something, ask ChatGPT if the text is correct, if there are any grammar mistakes. And practice different styles of writing, like essays, journaling, taking notes, writing a story, etc. 5, of course, speaking. These days you can speak to apps. I used to talk to myself, you can speak with apps and they can give you feedback. And of course, focus on grammar. Key topics that you need to study. Different ways to talk about the future.
Conditionals.
Our favorite topic, of course. The I wish, if only, used to constructions. Passive voice. And focus on one grammar topic at a time. And of course, the more resources you can get access to, the better. We are working on an app for you, so hopefully I will be able to present something in one of my upcoming videos. We're still testing it, beta testing on smaller groups of our students, but this is something super exciting, and of course it's going to have AI components in it. Now in your final step five is practice, practice, practice. I'm gonna write it three times because it's very important. Anything you can do. Switch your computer and phone settings to English. Select a few days during the week when you consume content only in English. Try to talk to your kids in English. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching this video up to the very end. Here's a step-by-step plan on how you can improve. Of course, I just covered the basics. There are more aspects to becoming intermediate, but if you take a comprehensive course, if you learn with a tutor, then of course you're going to cover everything that you need. And I'm wishing you the best of luck with your language, and hopefully my channel is helpful and motivates you on this journey. Thank you so much, and I'll see you very soon in my next videos. Bye!